Well, hey there, good evening. Yeah, we're even seeing lightning in the Indianapolis area. Now we do have some heavier showers and thunderstorms just outside of the city on some of our western counties, as you said. And right now, current temperatures in the mid-70s. So the environment, what we're looking at, 57 degrees on the dew point. There's a lot of moisture to work with. On our live radar right now, you can see this cluster of thunderstorms right in that downtown area. So this is right here, just over Indianapolis, and we're hearing a lot of that heavy rain coming over our heads right now. Northwest of us is outside, but in Chicago, is right outside Chicago, where they got a tornado warning and a severe thunderstorm warning just behind that. But the overall setup here, low pressure system that's driving all of this. We've got this line of showers and thunderstorms that's rolling through Indiana right now. So we are under a risk for severe weather. None of our storms so far today, though, have reached severe criteria. So that's good news for now. Winds are out of the south, so we got a lot of wind energy pushing in warm, moist air from the Gulf, and you can just tell where that giant low pressure system is just northwest of us. So we're getting this, a warm front had already moved through. You can kind of see where it warmed the air up, right in the southern portions of Indiana. And then this cold front coming through is going to bring us more showers and heavy thunderstorms. And later on tonight, that's when it looks like we have the best chance to see some of these stronger storms reach severe criteria. Sustained winds rolling in around 20 miles an hour, so a lot of wind energy to work with, and gusts have been over 30 miles an hour at times. So looking ahead at our future view, we are looking at these stronger storms continuing for the next couple of hours. I will say, I think models have been initializing a little weaker. So what we've seen has been a little more intense than kind of what radar is putting out right now. But looking ahead to this evening, going on to 9:30 p.m., this is when we really are expecting we could see some stronger storms picking up. Now, we're going to be keeping an eye on this and kind of monitoring radar all throughout the evening. So make sure you're checking back in with us, especially on social media, on Weather Authority. 11 p.m. tonight, and that strong line of showers and storms still present, and we're going to keep watching this. I think the severe threat really picks up in about an hour, so about 7:30 to 1 a.m. tonight. So we're going to be really just kind of sitting here and sort of babysitting radar, and then we should be given the all clear in the early morning hours of Sunday. So by 4 a.m. this is when models have us drying out. I think we're going to dry out a little bit before that, though, and we should be all clear and good to go. Again, the best time frame to see that is going to be from about 7 to 1 a.m. when we really think that some of these storms could reach those higher wind gusts. But just looking at the overall environment, we've got this nice plume of moisture that we're working with, and we know our winds at the surface are pumping in some warm air out of the south. Now, at the higher level, so upper level wind flow, we've got this strong southerly push at the surface, but in the air aloft, it's moving this direction really quickly. So that's called wind shear. It's something that helps get those storms going and gives them energy. They change speed and direction with height, and we have that. We can also start to get some rotation going. So that's just something else that we look at to kind of show what our environment is that these storms are entering into. And we know the history of these storms. Just out west, there was a tornado warning right outside of Chicago. It's now expired by about 10 minutes now, and we're not seeing any current severe thunderstorm warnings or any warnings of that sort in Indiana at the moment. But again, this is something we're going to continue to watch. I want to show you my 7-day forecast is somewhere in here. Here we go. Temperatures over the next couple of days, we're going to be hanging into the low 70s. So we do have some nice warmer air to start off the month of May. And after these storms pass, we will be drying out and have a nice Sunday coming up for us as well.
All right, Alyssa, thank you. Developing now, Lauren.